ready to match the stars. Bill Macy, Brett Summers, Charles Nelson Reilly, Elaine Joyce, Richard Dawson, and Betty White as we play the star-studded Big Money Match Game PM. And now here's the star of Match Game PM, Gene Ryder.
Rascal. Oh. Hello there, group.
Hello.
Now, all of you are aware of the fact that we have three sterling characters who are regulars on daytime and nighttime match game, Richard and Charles and Brett. And now let's see. Is this the first time for the three of you on? No, you've been on nighttime.
Yes.
Have you been on nighttime?
Yes, I have.
Oh, well, what the heck
I've
am I talking about?
I've also done this
show, PM. Oh, you've done this show, too. That's right. And oh, here we go. Oh, Bill hasn't.
This is the first time for me anytime.
Anytime.
Very
well,
good.
Let's welcome the new kid on the block, shall we? Thank you, Bill Macy. Okay. Yeah.
You realize that on this show, I will be breaking my blank.
You will. Well, I hope you'll do your best, too. Now let's say hello to our two players over here, Richard Edwards and Lisa Kersey. How do you do?
Hi, Gene. How are you?
What do you got there?
Up with this mob tie.
Isn't that something? Now, we wish you well, both of you, and we want to find out something about you. Lisa, shall we begin with you?
Okay. I'm from Placentia, and I'm a student, and I want to be a stewardess, and
yeah.
I have a terrific family and a great boyfriend.
Well, that's marvelous. Good luck to you here, Lisa. How about you, Richard? What about your life?
I'm from San Diego, sales manager for a national company manufacturing coffee brewing equipment.
Mm-hmm.
We just got back from Europe. We were over in England for 2 years. Been married 18 years to the runner-up of Miss England in 1955. We have four children, ages 17, 16, 12, and 3.
1955. Wish you well, too.
Thank you.
Now, I want to point out to both of you that you'll be trying to match as many celebrities as you can, and then the winner will go on to play the Big Money Super Match, which can pay off over $10,000. Here we go. Lisa, please make your selection.
Okay, I'll pick B.
B it is.
B.
Are you ready?
Yep.
Sure.
Here we
go.
The Godfather said...
Don't do it.
Oh, all right. Okay. Godfather
ahead,
said, I'm a changed man. I no longer shoot guns. Instead, when I get mad... at a guy, I throw a blank at him. I can't even read it in my own voice. He says, I no longer shoot guns.
You
instead, when I get mad
yes.
at a guy, I throw a blank at him.
He don't shoot no more guns.
He don't shoot no more guns.
No.
Instead, when I get mad at a guy...
I told you not to do it.
Ready.
I bet you're wondering.
All right.
Now, don't shout at me because I'm almost finished.
If you're finished, Bill, then what we do here is you turn it upside down so no one can
I'll
see it.
Tell him.
And put
I'll
it in the sun.
Him.
You do your thing. It's my show. Now stop that.
But I'm supposed to be the guider up here.
Yes.
She's got about one good year left
very
in
good,
her, I think.
Oh, I forgot to put mine in.
Instead, when I get mad at a guy, I throw a blank at him. Everybody ready? All right, we'll call on Lisa. The Godfather said, I'm a changed man. I no longer shoot guns. Instead, when I get mad at a guy, I throw a blank at him. Now, that's the Godfather speaking.
Right.
You do understand that.
Right, right.
Okay.
A horse's head?
A horse's head. Betty White,
oh, I would rather
animal
she,
lover par excellence. Oh, is going
I mean, the
to be,
other end of the horse, I wouldn't mind.
Yes, yeah, but not the horses.
You are
yet.
Married to that.
Now, Bill, we call on you.
Yeah, I can understand why she said horse's head because I saw the picture too.
That was part of the picture, sure.
And I just chose a different scene.
Really?
Yes. And remember, he was on Mulberry Street?
Yes.
And he was picking various things, and he drew a tomato out of it.
A tomato.
A
okay. A tomato, all right.
That means that's wrong.
When you hear the buzzer.
Oh, I'm sorry.
Like that.
You were
You'll
wrong.
Get used to that sound, sweetheart.
Brett, leave him alone.
First, what? I want to tell Betty White I killed 7 flies before I left home. And
she
then I
talked
want to
them
say,
to death.
Yeah. She said you talked them to death. What do you say now? Show us your answer.
You know what he did?
What?
He killed, I threw a lemon cream or meringue pie.
Well, isn't that the answer?
No, that's not the answer. It's the Godfather.
I know, but wait, she just got so, like Charles Nelson Riley,
when
she
someone,
just started throwing cream
come on,
pies.
Stop that. When someone comes up with a good answer, the audience will scream and applaud and holler and fall out of their seats, and
now
you'll know
Charles
a good
answer.
All right, Charles, you're up.
First of all, they will do that when I show my answer, because it's terrific.
It is.
And second of all, tomorrow morning, I want to come, because I'm going to bet on the 7 flies that'll get you tomorrow. Said, and here it is, but destined to be one of the big all-time nighttime favorite answers. Meatball.
Meatball. Italian meatball. Pizza, meatballs, you know, anything like, you see. Oh. Hello there.
Hi.
Are you ready?
Yeah, you want to hear a great answer?
A great answer is coming up. Now,
right.
Wait a minute.
Go right to
Godfather said, I'm a changed man. I no longer shoot guns. Instead, when I get mad at a guy, I throw a blank at him.
He no longer shoots guns.
Right.
He throws guns at him. That was the worst.
I think the Romans are gonna throw you to the lions.
I hope so.
Now, Richard. Now listen to this.
Here comes a good answer. Come
here on. Comes a good answer. Wake up!
I throw a plate of spaghetti at
him. A plate of spaghetti. Oh, he's gonna get you for that. They don't allow that. Now, you, madam.
I'm on the wrong... You've been watching. I'm
yes.
on the wrong wavelength, but I thought it was the Godfather, right?
Yeah.
He threw a body at him.
A body! Sorry, there's a no horse's head for you there. Now, let's see what we've got for you, Richard. Listen carefully now.
Oh.
Gunga Dingy, the snake charmer.
Gunga Dingy?
Gunga Dingy, the snake charmer, was such a rotten musician when he played his flute, his snake blanked. How rotten a musician he was. When he played the flute, the snake blanked.
Say his name again, because that's more rotten than the snake.
Gunga Dingy.
Okay, what happened?
When he was a rotten musician, you see, and when he played his flute, his snake blanked. The past tense of whatever the snake did is what we're after, Charles. You finished? You finished. She's drawing diagrams to make sure we understand it. Finish.
I finished first.
There. We're waiting for... He's ready. All right, just put it there in a slot there, Charles, and away we go. Here we go, Richard. Gunga Dingy, the snake charmer. He was such a rotten musician. When he played his flute, his snake blanked.
Cried.
Cried?
Answer.
Well, that's not one of my all-time favorite answers, but it's a possible. Well, let me see what you've got, Bill.
Well,
wake up.
I am.
Now, wait a minute. That's the best he can do.
It is my first time, the same as Richard's. And so both of us must be on the same wavelength because I have cried.
Oh! Okay, Bill. You may now retire. Brett?
And I have something else to tell Betty. Last night I shot a nightingale. Hissed.
Such a rotten position
so
when he played his flute, his snake hissed.
Oh, my goodness.
But the snake's
out there. Out there, the likes of which I can't begin to describe.
Charles?
Well, if the audience can read lips, they can get this. It's...
Gunga Dingy, the snake charmer, was such a rotten musician when he played his flute, his snake blanked. And Richard said, cried. What do you say?
Well, he cried, yeah. We assume that. But then he just curled up and died.
Now there's an answer.
I got a hit, my first rabbit!
That's right. You got it.
Yes!
Yay!
He
his foot is snake blanked. Cried.
Honestly, say, I never thought a time would come when snake dying would get round of applause.
Thanks for looking out.
When he played tune.
Yes.
Snake bit him.
There is something I would like to know. Would you please tell us what kind of snake was this that he...
This was a rattling snake.
A rattling snake.
Had swallowed a pencil, you pick him up and rattle him. Give one, please.
All right.
No more Indian stories.
I thought you had an ending for this piece, but
you did not
have an ending. It could have been
didn't
an
Didn't have
ass,
a beginning. Wasn't too crazy about middle.
Betty White, honey, what do you say?
As in Richard's last piece of material, it died.
It died. Okay. Round one is over. Scores 1-0 favor Richard. Round two will come along after this message or two. Here we go. Round two coming up. Now, let's see. Richard, the score is 1-0 you favor, so therefore we ask you to go first.
I'll take the B, please.
B it is. B. One person does not play, and
that's
that is
Bill, our new best friend.
Because you matched him in the first round, so that you lay out this
May
time,
I smoke?
Okay? Right.
We don't mind if you burn.
The Jolly Green Giant said to the doctor, he says, gee, Doc, I'm worried. You know how a leaf turns brown and then falls off a tree? Well, my blink just turned brown. You understand everything I said?
I sure did.
Gee, Doc, I'm worried. You know how a leaf turns brown and then falls off a tree? Well, my blank just turned brown. Ho, ho, ho. Isn't that what he does?
Just
I'm ready.
Oh, you're ready.
Was it the Jolly Green Giant?
The Jolly Green Giant is talking.
Oh, for heaven's sake.
You've got to listen.
I have a listening, but
decision. I didn't have my hearing aid.
The Jolly Green Giant.
No, my major decision.
Would you like to come into my office and consult with me?
I have to decide whether I want to continue in this business.
Now, yes,
and
you do.
Yes, okay.
Jolly Green Giant.
All right.
Ready, ready, ready. Ready, ready. Here we go. Now. Richard, the Jolly Green Giant said to the doctor, gee, Doc, I'm worried. You know how a leaf turns brown and then falls off a tree? Well, my blank just turned brown.
Bottom.
Bottom, huh? Well.
Let him laugh, Richard. I bet you five of them haven't.
No. Brett, what have you got?
Oh, he had a little vegetable garden.
Had a vegetable garden.
He had little peas and he had little carrots. His carrots turned brown.
His carrots turned brown.
Yeah.
Okay.
That's a sweet answer.
Yes, it is. Charles?
I said his green bean.
His green bean turned brown. Really? They're all playing it straight, Richard. Hi, you know, they're supposed to be the funny, and you're there, but they're all... All right, you, madam.
Could I think about it a little while longer and you can come back to me?
So you want me to preview your answer?
It's his can of peas turned brown.
That's right. The buzzer seems to be getting louder, or is that my imagination?
You know, one more lousy...
Yeah.
Listen to that back!
Three people are applauding. Cut. Richard?
Yes, I happen to know the... I knew him very well.
Yes.
And his niblets turned brown.
Okay. Now, what do you say, Betty White?
Falling off at the end here is corn.
It's corn. So, it's 1-0 at this moment. Now, we come to you, Lisa. You've got to match one celebrity to stay in the game. If you match two, you win the game. Here we go. Jim said, my new wife has a weird idea of what's fun. On our wedding night, she blanked me up. Jim said, my new wife has a weird idea of what's fun. On our wedding night, she blanked me up. Everybody plays, since she didn't match anybody in the first round. And don't think too long. Trust your first instinct, and you write the answer down on the card.
Oh, sure.
Okay.
Could we have a conference?
It's a good answer.
No.
Trust the answer.
Well, wait. Hold on.
We're going to have a whole conference.
Hold on. Let me just check that. No.
Charles and I
That's
liked it.
Good, yeah, of course.
Of course.
All right. Put that in the slot there, Bill. And we're all set. Elaine, are you still fooling around?
No, everybody's ready.
So, Lisa, Jim said, my new wife has a weird idea of what's fun. On our wedding night, she blanked me up.
She picked me up.
Picked me up.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yes!
She said, pick me up, Bill. What do you say?
Well, it could have been that, except that he was all slippery from being shampooed.
On our wedding night, she shampooed me up. Well, whatever. It turns you on, Bill. Okay, Brett.
Well, he was all washed up.
Yes. Brett? Yes.
Okay. Tied.
Tied me up. Oh. Yay. Oh, all right, Charles. Yes.
I said cranked me.
Okay, Lisa is looking for the answer. On our wedding night, she picked me up. What do you say?
I said that at night she made him up.
She
was asleep.
All right, that sweet answer.
That's a lot of fun. You ought to try it. Your husband will look better to you.
Cut it. Go.
I said tie.
Tie. Got to match Betty to stay in the game. Betty, may we see it, please?
I have learned not to judge from personal experience, or I would have said woke me up, but yeah. I said tied me up.
Tied. So that means Richard wins the game. Stand by for a moment or so now here. Going to say goodbye to Lisa Chrissy.
Thank you. I had a really good time.
Lisa, we've got a gift for you together with our thanks for being with us here on Match Game PM. Goodbye, Lisa. And while we're spinning her off, we're going to spin these messages just for you. Ready? No, here we are now with Richard Edwards Jr. And Richard, it's time for the Big Money Super Match, where you can win over $10,000. Now, to do that, we have two audience matches for you. And whatever you win in these audience matches, you'll have a chance to multiply by 10. Ready?
Ready.
All right, here we go with the first one. We polled a recent studio audience, and we got their best response to this. Blank cocktail. Blank cocktail. Now, if you match the answer they gave most often, you get $500. If you match the next one, $250, and the bottom one, $100. Which celebrities would you like a little help from?
I've got a good one.
We'll start with Elaine.
Okay. Get ready, gang. Shrimp cocktail.
Shrimp cocktail. Yeah. That's it. Okay, there's one.
Richard?
Pardon?
Richard, blank cocktail.
I don't drink. This is very difficult for me.
Yes.
I'll go into a conference.
Yes.
of course.
What?
Are you calling me names? Fruit cocktail.
All right.
Thank you.
Okay, one more.
And Brett.
Wouldn't you know?
Third is tough.
Well, the only thing... Oh, yes, you. I already had fruit, you fruit. And I've got crab meat, too.
So your crab meat cocktail. So those are the three, Richard. Crab meat cocktail, shrimp cocktail, and fruit cocktail. Do you want one of those? Or is there a better idea floating around in your head?
No, I'll have the fruit cocktail.
Ordering one fruit cocktail coming up here. All right, that's the one he's looking for. We'll find out if it's there. May we see the $100 response? Molotov cocktail.
Oh, are we off?
That's a great drink.
Dangerous, yes indeed. Fruit cocktail, is it under the $250 response? Shrimp cocktail. That's the one that Elaine gave you. All right, last chance for the fruit cocktail. Here is a $500 response.
Fruit
cocktail.
I'm not surprised.
You've won the $500, which means that the least you'll be playing for is 10 times that amount, or $5,000. Now we're going to see how much more you can win with a second audience match, and here we go. We polled another studio audience, and we got their best response to this. Blank and the roll. And the answer they gave, you know, is $5,000, $250, $100. Three celebrities going to give you a hand here. Whom do you call on?
Richard?
I was going to say shrimp, but I will say... Rock and roll.
Rock and roll.
Charles.
Charles, have you got one?
What?
Esther and roll. No, I got
no. Blank and roll.
I got a wonderful one.
Go.
Definitely an audience pleaser. It's called Butter and Roll.
Butter and Roll. Okay, one more.
And Betty.
Betty,
oh,
have you
got
I knew it.
Did you ever know that the umbrella was going to come right down on your head?
Right. Yeah.
Now, third is
try
tough.
Crab meat.
Third is very difficult.
Third is very,
shrimp roll.
No.
Crab meat roll.
Knife and roll.
Fork and roll.
What did you call it? Yaw, you, when a thing, the space capsule does what? Yaw. Yaw and roll. No, there's one that they'll never think
yeah,
of.
Yaw and what?
Yaw and roll.
You should go to Hawaii more often.
So it's yaw and roll, butter and roll, rock and roll. Which one of those do you want, if any?
I think I'm going to go with the rock and roll.
Rock and roll is one we want. Let's find out what's up there and so where. Let's begin down at the bottom and reveal the $100 response. Butter and roll.
Well,
all right, it's not there. Is it under the $250 response?
Called an MC.
Shake, rattle, and roll. Last chance for rock and roll. Here's a $500 number. Rock and roll. $500 multiplied by 10 makes another $5,000. Added to your previous $5,000, you got $10,000 to shoot for. Here's the $10,000 question. You face me. Now, to collect this, you've got to match one celebrity head-to-head. Which one will it be?
Richard.
Richard, ready. Here we go. Blank beans, B-E-A-N-S. Blank beans. Okay, he's finished. Now, Richard, we ask you to give us your response, one you think will match his. Blank beans.
Green.
Green beans. The audience is owing you. I don't know whether that's a good or a bad sign. Richard, for $10,000, he says green beans will match you. What do you say?
I said baked.
Baked beans.
I'm sorry, Richard.
Okay, Richard, you didn't win the $10,000. However, you did win $1,000, and we thank you for being with us here on Match Game PM. It was a pleasure meeting you. Okay, we'll be back in a moment or so. Come right back. You were all terrific, and we hope to see you all again. And you too, join us next week for Match Game PM. Gene Rayburn here. Goodbye.
Some contestants will receive cool comfort from Frederick, leader in energy, efficient room air conditioners. Frederick lasts for years, saves you a lot of money. And record a call in, the automatic telephone answering system, voice actuated with remote control that plays back your message from anywhere in the world. And Proctor Silex Counter Magic Toaster Oven, a two-tray toaster oven that also broils and pops up toast. Another superior design from Proctor Silex. And Prestone 2, winter summer concentrate with its patented silicone silica formula. Fights winter freeze-up, summer boil-overs, and rust and corrosion in all seasons. And for a smooth-running car, Castrol GTX Motor Oil for all models and sizes of cars. Castrol lubrication for cars, motorcycles, and snowmobiles. This is Johnny Olson speaking for Match Game PM, a Mark Goodson, Bill Todman production.